ei käydä toista maailmansotaa kokonaan, mutta kysyn, että miten Hitler kenties näki Suomen roolin osana Saksan sotaponnistuksia. On puhuttu siitä, että esimerkiksi hän olisi ollut hyvin jopa pakkomielteinen Petsamon Nikkelin merkityksestä ja sen takia siellä oli suhteettoman suuret saksalaisjoukot. Mitä mieltä Kershaw on tästä?
Few questions about Finland in Hitler's view of war effort, German war effort. How important do you see for Hitler was Finland as on the northern flank, and especially the Petsamon nickel mines? Sometimes it's said that he was a bit obsessed about them and their importance and kept too much elite troops in north, which were not actually, which couldn't have been needed in the other fronts.
I don't think he was particularly obsessed in that way by the mines, but obviously that nickel was very, very important for the German war effort. For Finland economically had a significant place in the German war scheme. More importantly than just the economic advantages were, of course, the strategic position of Finland as controlling in many ways then the path to the path of the Baltic. And therefore, Finland, from this point of view, was of vital importance to Germany. And we see the efforts Hitler and the Nazi leadership made to try to keep Finland on side, to keep it on Germany's side, including naturally the visit to Finland by Hitler in June 1942, where he met Marshal Mannerheim when he went to Imola on that occasion. So. Very important economic strategically. So I think the Nazis saw, apart from that, no great interest.
Eli ehkä Petsamon merkitystä on Suomen näkökulmasta katsotun hiukan yliarvostettu sen taloudellista merkitystä Saksan sotaponnistuksella. Totta kai se oli strategisesti aseteknologisesti tärkeä metalli, mutta sama tavara oli kyllä saatu sitten muualtakin. Eli Suomen merkitys oli taloudellisesti ehkä tärkeää, mutta sotilastrategisesti Itä- ja Itä-rintaamaa pohjalla reunustalla aivan elintärkeä. Tämän takia Hitler käytti diplomatiaa ja tuleva itse Suomen käymään Mannerheimin syntymäpäivänä varmistaa sen, että Suomi todella pysyy Saksan rinnalla. Vielä siitä, eli tällaista rotunäkökulmaa. Suomi ei ollut arjalainen kansa. Esimerkiksi Kaupassa saksalaiset kohtelivat valtteja toisen alempiarvoisen rotun. Onko tällaista näkemystä ollenkaan? Is there any racial skepticism about the Finns being nation and, let's say, right in the Baltic states, the Germans treated them as not as a role?
No, I think, as I was saying, there wasn't any real interest in Finland as such beyond the strategic and the economic. So the racial issue was one which was totally secondary in the Nazi leadership's thinking of this. After all, Germany was in an alliance with Japan, so race was completely subordinated to the interests of the war. Had Germany won the war, then of course other questions would have come into play, and certainly pressure would have been placed upon Finland to deliver its use, for example, up to the Nazis for deportation to the death camps. But as it was far more important to keep Finland in line than was to worry at all about racial issues, and hence Finland was left more or less alone. In actual fact, for Hitler, these entire issues of racial allegiances amongst the German allied countries was one which was never absolutely prominent consideration as long as the war was being waged. Later on, it would certainly have been a central issue.
Sodan olosuhteissa rotukysymykset, varsinkin suhteessa liitolaisiin, olivat täysin alisteisia, toissijaisia sodan määriin ja sodassa pärjäämisen kannalta. Tässä suhteessa kysymys ei ole sotunut Suomen kohdalla missään vaiheessa. Se olisi järjestelmän seuraus, mutta se on sitten tapahtumatonta historiaa. Viimeiseksi ajattelin viitata suomalaisten rakastamaan ja yrittämään teokseen Mikko Huovisen Peitikkaan, joka on satiiri Hitleristä ja Hitlerin. Siinähän on yksi tällainen teema, että Hitlerille tämä koko homma oli eräänlainen jekku, ja hän jopa hävisi sen maailmansodan melkeinpä tarkoituksella. Ja minusta tuossa elämäkertaa lukija nyt, niin tämmöinen kohtalon omaen aikani on kulmassa tyhjiin. Siksi pitää kiirehtiä sotaa. Olen täyttänyt jo 50 vuotta. Tämän tyyppinen saman hillanen täyseen tuhoon asti. Tapaa tangeraa tähän huomisen Kershaw mielipide siitä. We have a classic satire on Hitler by his author, which says that for Hitler, this whole business of Nazi Germany and Nazi rule and the Second Wars, a war we know, but actually Hitler almost lost on purpose that he wanted to take the German with him. But in your book as well, there's a sense of urgency. He's already beating. The war is coming and he's the only one who can make it work. And this shadow of death hanging on him already in the late 30s. Kind of suicidal fatalism in his character. How would you comment this?
Well, it's true that by the late 1930s, Hitler was increasingly aware of his own health, his deteriorated health. He didn't have too long to live and he wanted to accomplish his goals in his lifetime. But there was a wider sense in which time was the essence for him, which was that he knew how powerful Germany's enemies were, and that Germany, if it were going to gain the supremacy in Europe as a basis for later world supremacy, then this could only come at in the near future at very rapid speed. Hence, whatever steps he took, defeat of Poland, for example, immediately he wanted to turn around, not after 7 months, but immediately. And this notion that if we don't actually accomplish this very quickly, we'll have the power of the United States to contend with, and we don't know how to be the United States, was another problem. So it's true that there was a type of urgency of time in his own view. It's true also that there was a sort of self-destructive streak in Hitler, and made a suicidal streak, which meant that the end would actually happen, the death in the bunker was the most likely way that would end. But at the same time, you shouldn't presume, which I think was the implication of your side, that Hitler deliberately intended to lose the war. Of course he didn't. He set everything out to win this war, to win it by 1942 or 43, before anyone else had the chance to rearm, to be in a position to compete with Germany. Time was against him personally, time was against Germany, and all this race of time drove him along.
Tällaisia henkilökohtaisia viitteitä toki voi erottaa Hitleristä, mutta toisaalta tämä kirjain tuttu ja ei ollut omaleman kanssa tässä mielessä, vaan se oli myös strategisesti perusteltu, koska Euroopan muut suurvallat olisivat vahvistuneet, joten aina Hitlerin Saksan oli hyökättävä, oli tehtävä se nyt, koska ei ollut näköpiirissä se viivyttämällä. Olisi oma sujunut paremmin. Tässä mielessä voisi sanoa rationaalinen Hitler kehityksenä tällaiset psykologiset seikat. Ja näin Hitlerin Saksa joutui taistelemaan. Oli luonnollista ja todennäköistä, että se päättyy Berliinin bunkkerin täydelliseen tappioon. Se ei suuntaan tiehen ollut se, Hitler tavoitteli. Ja näin kuitenkin taisteltiin loppuun asti, katkeraan loppuun asti, until the bitter end they fought. And then destroy. Thank you very much, Ian Kershaw.
Thank you for listening.